Hello friends, this is Gangadhar from the YouTube channel Maths Ganga. So now I am going to discuss solutions for two more questions from the JEE Mains 2018. And one question is the 40th one. Okay. This question is from the, you may call it as from the heights and distance applications of trigonometry. The question is given like this. PQR is a triangular park with PQ is equals to PR is equals to 200 meters. See, this is the triangular park. Okay. See, they named the triangular park as PQR. Right. So, this is P, this is Q and this is R. Also, they mentioned that this length is 200 meters and this length is also 200 meters. A TV tower stands at the midpoint of QR. You just consider a midpoint for this QR. Okay. So, a TV tower stands like this at the midpoint of QR. Imagine it, okay, this is a three-dimensional diagram. So, we need to imagine something, okay. See, if you look here, as per the given problem, this triangular park is an isosceles triangle. Since these two are equals to 200 meters. And they mentioned that a TV tower stands at the midpoint of QR like this, okay. Then they mentioned the angles made by this TV tower at the top of the tower P is 45 degrees. And at Q, it is given as 30 degrees. And at R, also it is mentioned as 30 degrees. And they ask us to calculate the height of the tower. See, if you observe, if this is the height of the tower, okay, and if you join this R and then this peak top of the tower, then the angle between this MR and then this slant is the 30 degrees as per the problem. They mentioned the angle of elevation as 30 degrees. So, if this is the tower, then the angle between these two is 30 degrees. In the same way, if this is the tower, okay, then if you join from P to the top of the tower, then there the angle is 45 degrees. So, if we join P and then M, okay, if this is the TV tower, if you join P with this tower, angle between this line and then this height is 45 degrees. Since it is 45 degrees, if you observe, this TV tower is perpendicular to the height of the triangle, okay, and then if you join these two are, since the angle is 45 degrees, these two are equal. If H is the height of the tower, then height of this also H. So, height of the TV tower is equals to the height of the isosceles triangle because one angle is 45 degrees there. Okay. And then if you join this, if this, these two, the angle is 30 degrees. Since this angle is 30 degrees, okay, this is the hypotenuse and this line are the other two sides of the right angle triangle. So, we have a separate, if you separate the diagram will be like this. Okay. See, this is the height of the tower, okay, like this, and this is the tower, okay. And then, if you just, this has M, and this has R, this is the slant height, they mentioned that this angle is 30 degrees. Since this angle is 30 degrees, if you apply tan theta, you will get this one. What is tan 30 degrees? Tan 30 degrees is equals to H by MR. Tan 30 degrees is 1 by root 3 is equals to H by MR. From there, MR is equals to H root 3, so this value is H root 3. So, this is H root 3, this is H and this is 200 degrees. If you apply Pythagorean result, 200 square is equals to H square plus root 3H whole square. If you simplify it, directly you will get the value of H and that H is nothing but height of the tower. There ends the problem. Okay. This is the question from the JEE Mains 2018 from the topic application of trigonometry. See what is given? Given a right a triangular park PQR with two sides equal. So, the triangle is an isosceles triangle. At the midpoint of the QR, we have a TV tower. And the TV tower is joined to the endpoints, vertices of the triangle PQR. And making angle of elevations 45, 30, 30. Since this elevation is 45, height of the triangle is equal to the height of the tower. So, H and H. And since here it makes an angle 30 degrees, from the height of the tower H, we calculated the length of MR as H root 3. So, by applying Pythagorean result, because it is midpoint in isosceles triangle, the median also acts like an altitude. So, here it is 90 degrees. So, if you apply Pythagorean result for these three values, you will get the value of H as 100. And that is your answer. Okay. There ends the explanation for this question. Then, coming to the next one. For the next one, 41st one. Okay. In this paper, 41st question is given that two sets A and B is given. Okay. The first set A contains ordered pairs A, comma B such that mod A minus 5 less than 1 and mod B minus 5 less than 1. and second set B also contains AB, 4 into A minus 6 whole square plus 9 into B minus 5 whole square is less than or equals to 36. Okay. See, if you see, if you treat that A and B as some X and Y, and I am going to represent those sets A and B on the coordinate system, on X and Y axis. Okay. See, if you treat this as the X axis, and if you treat this as the Y axis, coming to the set A, the given values, the first values is given that mod X minus 5 less than 1, treating A as X. Since mod X minus 5 less than 1, we have that minus 1 less than X minus 5 less than 1. We know it. And then by adding 5 everywhere, you have that 4 less than X less than 6. Set A contains ordered pairs X comma Y, where the values of X are in between 4 and 6. So if you treat, somewhere we have 4 here, and then 5, and then 6 here. Okay, see, the values of X are in between 4 and 6. So we need to concentrate all the values between 4 and 6. That means if you join a line here, okay, 4, and if you join a line at 6, then we need to concentrate all the values between 4 and 6. Okay, so this 4 less than X less than 6 indicates all the points in between this region. And coming to the second equation also given like mod B minus 5 less than 1. In the same way, if you simplify, similarly for Y also you let that 4 less than Y less than 6. So on the Y axis also, somewhere you just took 4 here and then 6 here. Then if the Y values are between 4 and 6. So all the values between this 4 and this 6 are the values. So A have to satisfy the ordered pair X comma Y. So the values which are in between in this region along with this region. So this is the required region for the set A. Set A contains all the ordered pairs which are in this region. This is set A. Okay. This is set A. Then to represent set B, what it is given in set B? See, if you look, set B, in the same way if you treat A as X and Y as B, it is given that 4 into X minus 6 whole square plus 9 into Y minus 5 whole square is less than or equals to 36 is given. Suppose that initially it has 36. If you divide with 36, we have that X minus 6 whole square by 9 plus Y minus 5 whole square by 4 is equals to 1. So it is in the form of ellipse, the general form of the ellipse with the center X 6 comma 5. So in the center 6 comma 5. So X is 6 and Y is 5. So X is 6, Y is 5, and X is 6 means this line, this point. Y 5 means between 4 and 5. So at this point, we have the center of the ellipse. With that point, we need to draw an ellipse. Okay. And see, if you compare with the general form of the ellipse, like X minus alpha whole square by A square and Y minus beta whole square by B square. So from there, we have that A is equals to 3. And from here, when compared with the B square, we have that B is equals to 2. Since A is equals to 3, okay, the major axis is has to be 3 and 3. So this point is 6 comma 5. It will be 3 units. We need to move 3 units backside. So if you move 3 units backside, 6 minus 3 is 3. Somewhere we have 3 here. This is the one end point of the ellipse. And after that, 6 plus 3 is 9. Somewhere we have 9 here. So this is the semi-major axis of the ellipse. Whereas coming for the minor axis, since the value of B is 2, this is 5. 5 plus 2 is 7. Somewhere we have 7. And then 5 minus 2, somewhere we have 3. These are the endpoints of the minor axis. If you draw an ellipse like this, ellipse will be like this. So, if it is equals to 1, then the ordered pairs X, Y are on the ellipse. Since it is given as less than or equals to 36, set B contains all the points or all the ordered pairs which are lying in the ellipse. Okay, all the points lying in this ellipse are in set B. All the points lying in this region are in set A. Clearly, the points in set A are a subset of set B. Your answer is A subset B for that question. Okay. So, finally, what I did is, for the set A, I indicated in the coordinate system. The set of ordered pairs as set of points in the set A, I indicated as a rectangle. And the set of points satisfied in the set B are indicated by the ellipse. So, if you observe, the values of the ordered pairs in A are as a part of ordered pairs in B. So your answer is A subset of B. Okay, this is the explanation for the 41st question and your answer is option 1. Okay, these are the two more questions from the JEE Mains 2018. Okay, thank you. Do subscribe for the channel And I hope these videos are helpful. Okay, to follow the solutions for all the questions, okay, do watch the previous videos as well as the other videos. Thank you.